right. Thank you, Roger. Well, after 12 years of planning and $38 million, the Downeaster service from Boston to Portland will soon continue north with stops in Freeport and in Brunswick. And today there was a ribbon-cutting ceremony to mark another milestone in the project. News 8's Jim Keithley reports.
Hundreds gathered at the new Brunswick train station. The platform where trains will stop served as the stage as the ceremonial yellow ribbon was cut. And with that, they climbed aboard for a look inside. Mark Humphrey brought his young son.
Like I said, I hope it's a great success.
There's a lot riding on the notion that passenger rail service will be popular here in the Mid-Coast.
The Downeaster has been known as the Portland to Boston service, and now it's going to be known as the train to Maine.
The dignitaries who turned out to mark the milestone say the railway system has been an important part of Maine history since 1830. And passenger trains help drive local economies.
There's been some independent analysis done that shows over the next 18 years, the state of Maine will see $7.2 billion in private investment along this rail corridor, creating some 10,000 jobs and generating more than $75 million in additional tax revenues each year for the state of Maine, New Hampshire, and Massachusetts.
The economic impact for Brunswick can already be seen. This newly built train station houses several restaurants and other commercial businesses. And so the platforms are in place, but the trains won't actually start rolling until the fall. We're being told sometime in November. And tourism officials here in Maine say that this stop here in Freeport will have a significant economic impact.
Freeport's a top destination known obviously for its shopping, L.L. Bean, but also for the outdoors and its connection there. So, you know, it's just a great way to get in there, not only during the busy summer season, but also the shoulder seasons.
With two new stops, the Downeaster will churn even further into Maine, exposing visitors to other cities and towns with different offerings. And one day, they hope, the train to Maine will roll even further. Jim Keithley, News 8.